Hello everyone. So recently IFOA launched its handbook, examinations handbook of for April 2021 examinations. More or less everything is same as per the last time's examination. However, there are certain changes. Also, there are certain clarification done on a few topics. So in this video, I'll just take your 10 to 15 minutes to explain the changes, the updates which has been made by IFOA and few clarification on certain topics. So I've already marked a few things which I consider to be important. The very first thing is that you have in this handbook, it covers how you have to prepare for the examination and what all things you will require. So it basically deals with all of these topics. The very first thing, which is the very first update which has been done, is that now you'll require Microsoft Office 2013 version, the minimum acceptable version of MS Excel, MS Word. You'll require is MS Office 2013. For earlier examinations, it was 2010. So if you're using 2010 version, you'll have to update. You'll have to use a newer version. So the minimum version now, which they have specified, is 2013, right? So this is the first and the most important update which IFOA has done. What all things you'll require? The next thing you'll require is Adobe Reader. So any PDF reader, basically, because the exam paper will be in the form of PDF. So when you'll download the exam paper, it will be in the form of PDF. You require some PDF reader in your PC in which you'll be giving your examination. The best one you can use is the Adobe Reader, and they've also given the link for it. Then we have the internet connection. Good internet connection should be there. And then the next thing is zip file and loader. So basically, for those who have already given the examination, you all know that the question paper comes in the form of a zip file. So basically, whenever you, especially for Excel and R programming, it comes in the form of zip file, wherein all your data sets and all your files are there in one particular zip folder. So when you download that file, make sure, I've already said this in my one of the videos on the exam procedures and how to follow, what are the steps you have to follow in your examination. The link has been attached below in the description box. So here, basically, when you download the paper, it will be in the form of the zip file. What you have to do is you have to unzip that file. Do not forget to unzip the file, because most of the students, what they do is, in that particular zip file itself, they open the Excel file or they open any particular file and they start working in that itself. You will lose your work if you not save it and if it's in the zip file itself. So you have to unzip the file. What is the process? The process is there in my video, which I have mentioned the link below in the description box. So what you have to do, remember this very carefully. When you get the paper will come in the form of a zip file. So you zip folder, you have to unzip the folder and then you have to work with your data files, whatever is given. Now there are certain restrictions, as you cannot use pen, you cannot use handwriting if you have Surface Pro or all of these sorts of things. If you have a touch screen laptop, do not use that. You are not allowed to use that. These are the paper format in which you have to submit. So CS1, all the paper A will be in the form of Word, you have to submit, and paper B for Excel, that is CM2 and CM1 and CP2, will be in the form of Excel. And for CS1 and CS2, you have to work in R and you have to copy paste your answers and codes in the Word file, and you have to submit that particular Word file. All of the steps is given in my video, which I have attached below. Now, next thing we have over here is that you may use, this is a common question which we all of us face, is that when you are working, suppose you are doing CM1 profit testing table or any kind of calculations, you can use, see, it's given, you can use any other software package, which is R or Excel, to do your calculation. But make sure that all your calculations, full explanation of the calculation, is there in your Word answer script. Because if it is not there, then you will not get your marks. and the examiner might think that, okay, where from where are you getting this particular answer? You may not even awarded a single marks for that particular answer. So make sure, even if you're using Excel or even if you're using R for calculation, make sure you always put all the steps of the calculation in your answer script. Okay, this is very, very, very important. Otherwise, you lose your entire marks. So as I said, the versions which are required for MS Office is minimum 2013 or above. Also, one more thing, you will only have to use those functions which are there in MS Office 13. So you do not have to worry about, okay, which function to use, which not. Because obviously in CM1, CM2 and in CP2, we have already used only those functions which are there for 2013. Okay, so that this is only to protect those people who are using 2013 from, because you might be using the most latest version of 2019 maybe, and you might have certain functions which they might not have. So you have to use only those functions which are available for 2013, MS Office 2013 version. You do not have to worry about what all functions, because whatever we have done is there in 2013 only, right? Next, you cannot use dictation functionality in MS Word Office for those who are using Office 365, or for those who are using the latest version of MS Office. They have this dictation in their Word. You cannot use it. If you use it, you'll lose your entire marks. Your entire Word will not, your entire answer script will not be marked. Okay. You cannot use, for people appearing CS1 and CS2, you cannot use R Markdown or Knit R for compilation. You have to copy paste your R codes and answers into the Word. You cannot use R Markdown. This I also clarified in my last session's examination. Okay. Now, the formula and the notations, mathematical notations, which IFOA released in the last examination, they have again released the same notebook, but there are certain additions made to it. What are the additions? I'll tell you. These are the additions which have been made. So earlier, they didn't have any notation for the annuity functions. So they have added it currently, and you can see, for people who are appearing CM1, you have all the list of all the annuities and all the assurances which is given here. So if you face any issue, I have already attached my mathematical typing videos in the description box. You can see that. Also, along with that, they have added these different notations. Just for a quick tip, what they have done is, for the number of years, if you can see over here, they have put that into these brackets, these triangular brackets. So every time you see the number of years, it is always put within this triangular brackets. Okay, this is one quick tip for you to understand. All these assurances and all these annuity functions, we have dealt with in our mathematical typing videos. So you can go and look in the CM1. My mathematical typing videos I've already attached in the description box. So these are the new additions which they have made to the existing notation handbook which they gave us in the earlier attempt. Now it's an open book examination, as we know, because we are sitting at home and giving our examination. But there is a big but over here, what all you are allowed to do and what not. So even if you are using your material notes, you cannot copy paste everything word to word. Make sure you have learnt your concepts, you know your concepts. Only you can, maybe you can refer to the material. You have to write the answer in your own words. If they see that the answer is word to word similar to that of any particular notebook, any particular book or any particular website online, you will not get your marks. Maybe you will be called for as plagiarism. You will be sent an email by the IFOA that you have been involved in certain acts which were wrong, which were against their code of conduct. So you do not have to write everything word to word which is there online, or maybe which is there in your material, IFOA material. You cannot do that. You can refer to that. You can refer to your material and notes, but you cannot write word to word. You have to write it in your own words, right? This is first thing. Second thing, do not see, do not Google any of the answers. Do not see, do not check any website for any of your answers. You can refer your own notes which you have made during the course of your study, or you can use the IFOA material, nothing else. But also, if you're going to use these two, you have to use, you have to write your answer in your own words. You cannot write it word to word similar to that given in the material, right? This is the very first thing. Next, you are prohibited to sit together and give the examination, to share your answers with any but other candidate. If your cohort is cohort 1, you should not, you must not share your question paper with someone who is in cohort 2. Do not ever do this, otherwise you will be caught in the process of plagiarism. Okay, so these are the steps which they have strictly mentioned. These are strictly prohibited acts. If you do this, if you're caught doing this, you will be charged with plagiarism, and this will be, and your answer scripts will not be checked. Okay, next we have, so they have clearly said that our recommendation is that you answer everything in your own words. So now next question which crops up is that, if suppose there is a question which is exactly, suppose a definition or a proof, exactly these are present in the material, we have learned, we have memorized this. So it might so happen that the answer we produce will be very close to the one which is mentioned in the material. There is no issue in that. The IFOA Institute realizes that, okay, these definitions, the principles you have already done while you were studying for the subject. So they may not charge you on those basis where they will ask you about the definitions and principles or theorems. They will not judge you on the basis of that. But yes, you should have to remember this one particular thing, that if you copy paste entirely from the material, they will realize that you are doing so, because even if you are use word to word, even if you are copying pasting everything, they will realize. Learn, memorize the concept, produce it on your own in your own words. Do not try ever to write word to word answers from your material, okay? Because they have these kind of softwares which can detect that whether your answers are similar to your friends, or whether your answers are similar to any one particular textbook or online anywhere. Now the next thing is that how to sit for the examination. So basically these are the three important email addresses given by them. Through these three email addresses, all the communication will be done. All the login details will be sent to you before your examination. So make sure you have pinned all these three email address. I've already written this in the description box, so you can just copy paste and keep it handy with yourself, so that you may not skip any of the emails sent by these three email addresses. Okay, that is the first thing. Second thing is that 2 weeks before your examination, you will be sent an email for your login. You have to log in to a particular online platform where they conduct the examination. You have to go through a few steps about the login, the two-step verification. They follow the two-step verification where they verify your phone number and your email address, and then you have to do certain equipment checks, download and upload equipment checks. These details are everything there in my video. I have already attached it below in the examination procedure video. So you can just go through that video of 10 minutes and you will understand as to how and how to log in and how to do the equipment check. Okay. Now next thing, the very, very, very important thing for people who are appearing, for students who are appearing for the first time, the examinations are as per the UK time. So if they mention 9 a.m., that 9 a.m. is as per the UK time. Also remember, India is 5.5 hours ahead of UK, right? So if they are saying 9, our time will be 2:30, okay? So it is 5.5 hours ahead. Do not forget on that, okay? So the next thing is, as I mentioned, that 2 weeks before you will get the alert, you will get the login credentials using which the login, using the link you will log in into the examination platform, and the process is explained in my video. So I'm not going into that details. everything is again explained over here, but definitely I will suggest go through my video so that you can understand it better. Also, as they are going to use their your phone number, so remember this, that in your login, in your IFOA login, in your account section, you have mentioned your own phone number. Do not use anyone else's phone number. Use your own phone number, because the verification code during the login will be sent to your that particular phone number which you have mentioned in your credentials. Also the email address should be your own email address, because in that email address everything will be sent and communicated to. So if you are doubtful about which phone number is given, you just have to simply go to the IFOA login page, login, give your ARN and password, and within the accounts section you will see all the credentials, your email address, your phone number. Just see that your phone number and email address is correct or not. Okay, so all of these are explained in my video. I'm not going through this currently. Next, the moment you upload your answer script, okay, so this thing will appear, that which document have you uploaded. Make sure you see the name. You check the name of the document you have uploaded. So in my video, I have explained that in your Word file, you have to give your header as your ARN, your examination, suppose CS1B, CS1A, and then the term, which is April 2021. So three things: your ARN, your examination, which you are appearing for, the name of the examination, CS1A, CS1B, and then the term, which is April 2021. So that should be in the form of header. Also, the file name should be in this particular format. So when you upload your file, make sure that you check before clicking on the upload. Make sure you check that you have uploaded, you have selected the correct file. Once you have checked, it will ask you to upload and you will click on the upload. If you upload a wrong file, that will not be marked. It is not IFOA's fault, it is your fault that you have uploaded a wrong file. So make sure you are uploading the correct file. Okay, if you face any problem during your submission, suppose you are appearing for CM1 paper, CM1A, so your entire timing will be 3 hours 15 minutes. That 3 hours 15 minutes is for downloading the question paper, writing your paper, and then extra 15 minutes, once the 3 hour 15 minutes time is over, extra 15 minutes will be given for uploading your answer. So in that uploading your answer, if you face any issue, do not contact anyone else, or you cannot email them your answer script. They will not accept it. You have to call on this particular number. The moment you call and you give your reasons of why you couldn't upload the paper or why you are not able to upload the paper, they will authorize you that, okay, these are the problems, okay, we are granting you that you can submit your paper through the email. They will give you an authorization code. You have to send the mail to IFOA, your examination paper, you have to mail them. Along with, in that mail, you have to mention the authorization code, that you are authorized to submit your answer paper through mail, because it is not allowed to submit your paper through mail. They will not accept without the authorization code. So suppose in that 15 minutes time, you are facing internet issues or any kind of issue, take a screenshot of your computer, of your PC, that this was the issue which was showing to me, so that you have a proof. Remember, they will not work without a proof. So if you have a proof that, okay, you are not able to submit, maybe due to internet crash, or maybe due to the website is jammed or whatever it is, you have to click a photo of that so that you have a proof, firstly. Secondly, at that moment, you have to call the institute. You have to tell them your problem. They will authorize you. They will give you the authorization code. And once you get the code, along with that code, you have to submit. You have to mail them your file. You cannot simply mail them your file and expect that they will correct it, they will check it. No, they will not. You have to have that authorization code. But again, as I say, that it is always mandatory to start submitting your paper in that 15 minutes. Because if you don't submit within the 15 minutes, your answers will not be checked. It is a very slim chance that it will be checked through mail. Okay. Also, I have given this number in the description box, so you can just check. You can keep that number handy, the IFOA number handy. All of the things are explained to you in my video, that what you have to do in that particular day. When you receive the mail 2 weeks prior to your examination, what steps you have to take is mentioned in my video. So please take a look of that video. Make sure once you receive the email 2 weeks prior to your examination, you do the equipment check. How to do the equipment check is explained in my video. No matter how, you can take the equipment check many number of times, it doesn't matter, but make sure the PC or the laptop which you will be working on during the examination, you are performing the equipment check in that particular laptop and PC, right? So these are the steps which I have already explained. So it is your responsibility to save your work. So if you are using Word file, if you are typing, or if you are using Excel, make sure after every 10 to 15 minutes you are clicking Control S, saving your work. It is not their responsibility that you haven't saved your work after 3 hours 15 minutes. If you simply close your work and you haven't saved it, it's not their problem. It's your fault. They will not accept any apologies. Okay. So you have to save your work at every 10 minutes or 15 minutes interval. Make sure you are doing this. This will come with practice. When you are practicing, make sure you keep on saving your work. This is the format in which you will rename your file. Do not worry, I've explained this better in my video. I've explained this properly, and I've also shown how you can rename and how you can put the header in your particular Word document. Please make sure when you are uploading your file, you are uploading a correct file, because if you are not uploading the correct file, the answer will not be checked. It's not their fault that you have uploaded. Once you have uploaded the file, it's done. And once you upload the file on the portal, this particular thing will show that you have uploaded which file, what is the time of your upload. Same, you will get a mail as a confirmation that your answer script is received. What is the name of the answer script which you have given or submitted, and what is the time of your submission? Everything will be sent through the email to you as a confirmation that your answer script has been received by them. Okay. So if you face any issues, as I've already mentioned, you have to call this number. They will give you a unique authorization code. You have to mention this code in your email, and you have to submit your file in that particular email along with the code. So okay, that's it for this video. Please do have a look on the videos which I have attached in the description box. And if you have any further queries, you can comment that in the chat box. Thank you.